Hello students, in today's video we will be seeing about Putta Basappa and the rebellion of Surapura. Before getting into the video, if anyone is seeing the channel without subscribing, please do subscribe to my channel and share it with your friends. It will be a great encouragement for me to make more videos, and please do click the bell button to receive notification whenever I upload new videos. Without wasting time, let us get into the video. Putta Basappa. So in the last few videos we have been seeing about the revolt or the protest of the people of Karnataka against the British. We have seen about Dondia Vag, we have also seen about Kittur Rani Chennamma, and also about Sangolli Rayanna. So now, as a part of the rebellion of Amarasulya, we have studied about three main personalities, that is Swami Aparampura, Kalyana Swami and Putta Basappa. So in the last video we saw about the arrest of Swami Aparampura and Kalyana Swami. Now let us see in today's topic about Putta Basappa. The people of Lower Kodagu continued the rebellion after the capture of Kalyana Swami. So in the last video we saw that Kalyana Swami was captured in 1837 and he was placed in Mysore prison. So even after the arrest of their leader Kalyana Swami, the people of Kodagu continued their fight against British. Sulya, Ballare and Puttur, which were the major places of Kanara region, were part of Amarasulya. So all these places, that is Sulya, Ballare and Puttur, which were all these were part of Kanara region, they were part of Amarasulya. A farmer named Putta Basappa, claimed to be Kalyana Swami, took over the leadership of the rebellion. So even though Kalyana Swami was captured, this was not known among the people much. So taking this opportunity, a farmer named Putta Basappa claimed to be Kalyana Swami and he took over the leadership of the rebellion. The rebellion started in the hilly region, and Putta Basappa organized the rebels and calmed down the people. So the people were really upset over the situation, but Putta Basappa organized every one of them and he calmed down the people. He said that the tax on tobacco and salt will be withdrawn if the rebel government assumes power. So he made the people calm by telling them that if the rebel government assumes power, then the tax on tobacco and salt will be withdrawn. The rich farmers, landowners and local chieftains were quite assured of this move of Putta Basappa. So people were quite assured, especially the rich farmers, the landowners and local chieftains were quite assured of this move of Putta Basappa. So the people of Lower Kodagu region continued the rebellion even after the capture of Kalyana Swami. And the main places of Kanara region, that is Sulya, Ballare and Puttur, were part of Amarasulya. During that time, a farmer named Putta Basappa claimed to be Kalyana Swami and he took over the leadership of the rebellion. The rebellion started in the hilly region and Putta Basappa organized the rebels and calmed down the people. He said that the tax on tobacco and salt will be withdrawn if the rebel government assumes power. And this move of Putta Basappa was quite assuring for the rich farmers, landowners and local chieftains. And he took his first move in this rebellion by capturing government office in Ballare. So Putta Basappa took his first move, that is his first activity in this rebellion, was he captured the government office in Ballare. He killed an Amaldar who was known for his brutality. So he captured a government office. After that he killed an officer, that is an Amaldar who was known for his brutality. This increased the popularity of Putta Basappa. So on seeing all these, Putta Basappa became very popular among the people. Thus the rebellion became more famous and he gained more support. So slowly Putta Basappa started to become more famous and the rebellion became famous and it got support from many people. The rebels marched towards Mangalore to capture it. Now slowly the rebellion started spreading and they marched towards Mangalore to capture it. During this time the British were engaged in fortifying their fort in Mangalore. So during this time British, they were engaged in making or strengthening their fort in Mangalore. The rebels looted the treasury and prison of Bantwal. So they were going to Mangalore through Bantwal. So on the way, they looted the treasury and prison of Bantwal. The British sought the help of the army of Talicheri, Kannur and Bombay to quell this uprising. To quell means to end. Okay, so the British asked the help of the army of Talicheri, Kannur and Bombay to stop or to put an end to this uprising or to this fight. So Puttabasappa killed an Amaldar and this increased his popularity and this rebellion became very famous. So they marched towards these rebels, marched towards Mangalore to capture it, and they on the way looted the treasury and prison of Bantwal. Seeing this, the British wanted the help of the army of Talicheri, Kannur and Bombay to put an end to this uprising. And Puttabasappa came to know about this and he and his associates fled away to Sulia. So what happened was, when Puttabasappa came to know that British is taking the help of the army of Talicheri, Kannur and Bombay, he and his associates went or fled away towards Sulia. The British captured them with the help of the people in Kodagu, but finally they were captured with the help of some people in Kodagu, and Puttabasappa, Lakshmappa, Bangarasa, Kedambadi, Ramaya Gowda, Guddemane Appaya, all these were the important leaders of this rebellion. All were hanged till death. So British captured them, and the main leaders like Puttabasappa, Lakshmappa, Bangarasa, Kedambadi, Ramaya Gowda and Guddemane Appaya, all were hanged till death. Although the rebellion failed, it has an important place in the history of rebellions against the British. Although the rebellion was a failure, they were captured and many leaders were killed, but this rebellion has an important place in the history of rebellions against the British. So, British captured all of them with the help of people in Kodagu, and many leaders, including Puttabasappa, were hanged till death, and this rebellion has an important place in the history of rebellion against the British. So this is the rebellion of what we see in the rebellion of Amarasulya. In the Amarasulya, we saw about three leaders, that is Swami Aparampura, Kalyana Swami and Puttabasappa. Now next, let us see about the rebellion of Surapura. Surapura is 50 kilometers from the present day Yadgir. So Surapura is a place 50 kilometers from the present day Yadgir. And since the rule of Mughals, this was a very important place. So Surapura has a very a lot of importance in the history since the rule of the Mughals. This became a vassal state during the reign of Nizam of Hyderabad and Marathas. During the time of Nizam of Hyderabad and Marathas, this became a vassal state. So, Surapura is a very important place in the history. Later, most of the territory was lost and Surapura remained restricted to a small territory. So, during Nizam of Hyderabad and Marathas, it was a vassal state, but later it lost most of its territories and it remained restricted to a small territory. It was during the reign of Venkatappa that it raised a rebellion against the British. So here comes another leader in the fight against British from Karnataka. So it was during the reign of or the rule of Venkatappa that it raised a rebellion against the British. This much was an introduction to the rebellion of Surapura. The balance about Venkatappa Nayaka and what happened during his rule we will be seeing in the next video. So I hope you have understood all the points which I have explained in today's video very clearly. Please don't forget to like, share and subscribe to my channel. I hope to see you soon in the next video. Thank you for watching.